we have Mike.
Head this way, get some one-on-one interviews. Well, actually a scrum. Nothing one-on-one about this.
Tonya, how was your first experience of getting in there for an open workout as part of the UFC?
I do this every day, just it's kind of tiring when you're cutting weight, so it was cool. It was a little short workout, short and intense, it was good.
Tonya, one of the knocks on the Cyborg over the years has been she has not faced the toughest competition because there isn't a whole lot of fighters in that weight class that actually can fight. Do you feel like you can bring that and change the conversation and actually give her that good competition?
Yeah, I definitely think that I'm a step up in competition for anybody. Definitely for her, I think I could fight out of my weight class, up or down, either way, 10 pounds. So, you know, I think that when you look at her opponents and my opponents, I kind of feel like my opponents have been tougher in the past, and I've dominated them. So I think that ultimately this is a super fight. It's definitely going to be a good opportunity to prove that I'm up here where I need to be.
And how quickly did you take this fight?
As soon as they told me how much they were paying me, I take it. But other than that, no, I've been waiting to get an offer and for years and years and years, so it just came down to them actually throwing something at me.
What was the reaction? I mean, was it like you were happy or was it like, Jesus, finally?
Bittersweet. I mean, goddamn, man, I got to fight out of my weight class to get in. So, but, you know, it is what it is. I'm definitely the type of champion that fights anybody. I feel like I'm the best, so I feel like I can fight the best, and I need to fight the best, and I need to prove to myself how good I am, so... You know, there ain't nothing in this that's out of normal than I do every day when I come to work. So, just here to work.
Some people say it's like a no-lose situation for you, right? Like, if you win, amazing. If you lose, don't bring it back. You'll do 135. Do you look at it that way at all?
Well, I plan on winning, and then I'm sure we'll get a rematch with her. I'm sure that's part of the deal. It is part of the deal, but then we'll come back and fight again. So, that's my plans.
When you step in on Saturday, what do you think the weight differential will actually be by the time you both rehydrated?
Well, for me, I like when I cut to 35, it's a 30-pound cut. So it's a lifestyle change. So this is a 20-pound cut for me. I was already on my way down from Invictus. So I was already 10 pounds down, and I've been like starting to lose it and trying to eat as much as I can just to keep my weight up. I know that once we weigh in, my body doesn't put as much on as like her body's used to. She'll probably be walking at 60, 65. I think I'll be walking at 50, 55, so... 10 pounds, just, I mean, normal. She fights 10 pounds above me, so I think she'll just weigh 10 pounds more than me in the fight.
If you do win the title, you're going to stay at 145, right? You're going to stay and defend the belt.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if you heard, but that was a little bit of an issue before this fight where the champion didn't stay and defend the belt.
Well, I'm here to fight the best one in the weight class, so I'm obviously if I win that belt, I'm staying and I'm going to defend it and make as much money as I can while I'm doing it.
I mean, the rematch obviously seems like a natural if you win this fight, but I've never heard of it being, like, put in the contracts or anything. How did that all come about?
Well, obviously me and Chris have the same manager, so, you know, it's just one of them things. I think that he does a great job, and he knows what he's looking for, and he's experienced enough to know what I need if I do win this fight. You know, I'm not going to obviously win the title and then go down to 35. That makes no sense. For me, I'll fight 45, 35, 25 just to get as much fights in as I can before I have to retire or too old. So I'm gonna fight as much as they'll give me opportunities.
Do you think she has faced the caliber of a durable wrestler that you are and you've shown that throughout your career? Do you think she's faced anyone like that?
No. I think. I'm not saying there ain't like better wrestlers in this sport than me, but you know, there's probably better girls in the sport better than everything than I am, but I think what it comes down to is I'm able to put it together and be an ultimate, like, all-around, well-rounded fighter, and I think that that's part of it, you know, and I think that I'm a really smart fighter, and over the years I've created a style that fits me, and I know what kind of fighter I am and where I need to fight to win fights.
When you do get in the ring, what does that extra 10 pounds, how does it change what you can do and just how your body feels?
You know, I know when I fought at 35, a lot of girls would come and make weight, and then they'd be posting online how much weight they put on, and at the end of the day, I really don't care how heavy you are. I don't plan on that being a factor. That ain't a factor. I don't fight muscle for muscle and weight for weight. I'm a real, like, I guess I'm just a different style, man. I like to get out from underneath people. I don't like to carry their weight. I don't like to do things where I have to fight strength for strength.
Have you put together some kind of strategy or game plan? I know fighters don't like to give away their game plan, but is there a way in which you think you can get this done?
No, I don't game plan. I look at my opponent and I see, you know, where they're at and what they do, and I'll get opponents in my gym to train with me that are similar to her style. But I feel like if I game plan, if I go in there and get shut down, then that's the type of thing that breaks a fighter. That's the type of thing that's going to turn you over and make you feel like you're losing, and I don't like that feeling. So I go in open-minded, and wherever the fight goes, I'll take it and go with it.
Obviously, it's been fortunate for you to have those two fighters drop out. What did you think when Jermaine and Megan let it fight?
I think it's coward. I think when you have a belt, you're supposed to fight the best there is. That's what being a world champion is. So you fight everybody they put in front of you. You don't say no to anybody. And I think that, in Jermaine's sake, I think that she just she knew she wasn't the champion. You know what I mean? I think that she knew she wasn't going to win that fight, or didn't have confidence that she wasn't going to lose that fight or win.